Good evening, you handsome lot. I got a 2015 Audi A5 with a bit of a DRL from on the front left of the vehicle.
Right, well, I think the first thing that we need to do with this vehicle is get the diagnostics, which is a launch Euro Tab 3, and we're going to be having a little look to see if there's any fault code stored for this light, which there probably will be. Let's have a little look. Now, the fault codes that we are getting for this vehicle is a supply voltage for left LED module, daytime running lamp and parking lights. So you have a little look and get involved. I think the best thing that we need to do is get the vehicle up in the air and get both front wheels off. And the reason why I want to take the both front wheels off is because we're going to try, I think first, just to confirm that it might be the module, it could be the wiring, but we need to check it. And if it is, we're going to swap the module from left to right to see if the fault follows. And if it is, we can go ahead and order a new module for it. Well, after a little bit of fiddling, absolutely pointless exercise, taking the front wheels off because there's nothing accessible from the inner wheel arches on the bottom there. So the headlights themselves, they do pull out through the front, which is lots of little screws that you need to take out. Thing I like about these Audis, bolt storage. Look at that, perfect. Now, the LED modules themselves, they are on the bottom side of the headlight and they're held on with three T30s. Now, I have taken the one out of the passenger headlight. I'm going to go ahead now and take the one out of the driver's side. We're going to swap them over and see if that light works with that module. Right, well, plot twist. I have taken the module out of this one, which I will do now. Take it out. Maybe come around to the driver's side. I don't know if you can see. Well, yeah, you'll be able to see it illuminating. If we plug it in, that DRL is now working. So we know that there's absolutely nothing wrong with that module. Let me put it back in the headlight. Did flash on for a second there. That one's on. Now, right, let me just show you something. Hang on. And if we come back round to the headlights, I've even swapped these little LEDs over and it makes no difference whatsoever.
If you would like a better understanding of diagnostics and you want a free multimeter, head over to my Linktree, click the Mechanic Mindset, and for your first month, if you use a discount code SENDIT, your first month is going to be free. If you subscribe for the 12 months annually, you get a free multimeter. What a bargain, eh?
Now, I have checked wiring diagrams. Now, for the DRLs, this headlight is getting 10 volts. And this headlight is getting battery voltage of just over 12 volts. So we have got a bit of a voltage drop from there to wherever that goes. I'm presuming it's the body control module or somewhere like that. It's another plot twist. Right, well, I've had to scoodle along and put this car back together because we are clocking on, getting on with the day. Now, I've spoke to the customer, and the problem is with this vehicle, like I said earlier, we're getting 10 volts here, battery voltage there, we've got a problem from there, somewhere. Now, the wiring loom does run along the wheel arch, and the wheel arch there. So, well, that, obviously, with the wheel was off, I pulled the arch lining down, and I've just visibly checked for any little bits of green, but everything seems to be okay. So unfortunately, I'm either going to have this vehicle back in for me to have a look at it when I've got a little bit more time, or send it to an auto electrician and let them have a little look. Now, I could do it, but it's just getting, like, one of these jobs, you all know, it could take 5 minutes, it could take a week, it could take months, it could even be another module inside the car that's failing, or a little bit of water ingress somewhere on all four side lights. Absolutely stupid, but yeah, unfortunately not the outcome that I wanted today, because it's not very often that I send a car off the ramp that isn't fixed. But we can't win them all, can we? And I'm being honest, straight up. And I did say to the customer, straight from the start, with it being an intermittent fault, wait for it to fail and we can do some further checks. And that's what we've done. I was under the impression that it was going to be that DRL module that had failed. Because it is quite a common fault, that is, to be honest. Now, with me swapping them over, that has just proved that there's nothing wrong with the DRL module. But anyway, if you've liked what I've done content-wise, like how I work, please hit that like and subscribe button. We will see you on the next. Let's get it sent.